Thank you. Thank you. What? Let's fucking go. Let's fucking go. Holy shit. Fuck Knicks 2. Holy. Oh boy. All right. There we go. Knicks 2 Yeah. Oh my god. The entire time since Knicks 2, I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna miss it by like 5 seconds. Like, the amount of time I lost on Knicks 2. I'm gonna lose it just by that, aren't I? Still breathing. No, the breathing's kind of involuntary now. Now it's very much, elevated heartbeat and breathing. Holy crap. Well, thanks for the GGs, Bonus, Arflinier, Buxel. $131.58. Let's go. Now I'll never play it again. Hey man, you got a big save on me on Knicks 2, alright? So yeah, I was plus 3 on Nick 1. It was actually a really good split. It was a really good Domina too. I think I got out of Domina like a second or two earlier than I normally do. That Domina time felt insane. Then Nick's was really good. I did not get Poverty Skip though. Well, I actually got the Synchro, but I didn't have enough Lucre. So I lost some time here. Flame of Hope, I actually way oversold. I just went through and started selling everything, and I ended up with like 800 Lucre, and then I bought the sword and still had 600. So, like, I way oversold on that. Tea Time was really, really good. Everything there went pretty spot on. No Flowerling drops, no Spiral Claw, but that was still really, really good. But pull to Weapon Buy, again, like, I already had the money, so saved some time there. Finally hit that time save on Hunt and Ducate. Finally hit it. Still a second or two left to save there, I think, but that was really close. It was actually pretty... It was near perfect, I think, until the Ducate fight. I got kicked away again, because for some reason I just dropped a power cancel. Murmuring was a little rough. The zombie fight didn't go ideally. And then the second zombie fight, I think one of them started to walk away. So that was a little annoying. Two Torches was really good. It was one ST and one Evade, but it was, like, really fast. I think the Bowling Ball is the fastest ST he can use, so that was nice. Gorgon and I lost a little bit. It was a... Would have been a perfect Gorgon and I fight if I didn't 3-combo the very last combo. If I did another double tap, then I could have gotten one more power cancel off before having to go back to normal attacks. But, I mean, still, it was still pretty good overall. We're not talking about that split. And then, yep, got the 0 ST on Hound in Search of Faeries was fine. I really like the top blind spot. It's been working for me, like, every time. Like, the only time it doesn't work is if he instant STs. But besides that, if I move up, he either jumps in or he just stays in place and I can move over and start hitting him. Mines was really, really nice. Everything there went pretty well. I think all the normal fights went well. There was just one unfortunate red hand that I think I got like a couple hits on and then went for its ST. But wasn't like a last hit ST, luckily. It was just got a couple hits. So it was a minor time loss there. Dream Teller saved about a second. I might have split early there. That's how I felt when I got the gold on Dream Teller before. I was like, did I split early or something? Starcrossed would have been a good bit better if I didn't bonk. There's just a lot of like little things. Like I think on all three of the fights, like I think I got hit by the mummy ape, and I think both the succubus and the chest knight like moved out of a hit once or something like that. And then the Dana fight I also missed a counter, but I think I got her to a pretty good spot with counter canceling and weaving in power attacks after that. Infernal Doll, I'm surprised I saved that much time there, because I got all XP drop at the very end, or all Loot Gray drop, so I was not expecting. The Lizardon fight was really, really good, but I actually missed an attack on the Moldigoo, so I'm surprised I actually got that. My movement felt really good. I didn't bonk on anything. I think I, like, weaved through, like, weaved through like, each path really, really well. Faerie's Light. I think I have a few seconds to save here. I know I messed up the diagonal input to place Moon's Mirror, so I lost a little bit of time. And then... oh, yeah, and then I had slow menuing, because I moved down instead of up. Is it faster just to move up there all the time when you buy a sword? I never really thought about that, but I guess... it would be closer to the bottom, wouldn't it? Yeah, that was a really good Heaven's Gate. I had to second try the Selva skip. But, I mean, it was a very quick second try. I got it, like, right off the bat on the second attempt. I kind of did it the first time, noticed I wasn't going through, and just immediately reset. It seems like it's really easy to reset on that one, too. Like, if you don't get it, you can just do a quick little loop-de-loop, and, like, you'll instantly, like, get the line up again. Yeah, everything went really well. All the fights felt really, really good there. Except there was, like, I think that one Narcissus imp fight where, like, the imp didn't really move forward a lot. But yeah, everything else was pretty... oh, wait, the snake and, what's that thing called? The trident fish? That fight was... that was a meme. I was trying to power cancel the snake to get the last hit in, but I guess, like, I was... on top of his hitbox, but the sword was going far enough ahead to hit the fish instead, and then I kept getting bubbled, so that was scary for a second, but I don't think that cost too much time. It was just a kind of unfortunate little area. Yeah, Irwin fight went well, then yeah, Cage of Dreams, that was, I think I got a few more item drops there. I also did the spring ball fight better. Sahagin. Yep, that's what it's called, Sahagin. Oh yeah, Cage of Dreams. Yeah, I think a few more item drops. Spring ball fight went a little bit better. Yeah, that's about it. Saved a couple seconds there, which is actually brings it pretty close to my gold time, I think. And then... Mana Tree, I'm not sure how that stacks up versus the last Mana Tree split I had. I forgot to re-enter that before this run, because I know it was gold, but I forget exactly what it was. This one also felt pretty good. It started off the same as the last one, where I got the good Sky Dragon and then got the bad Land Dragon. But everything after that was pretty good until the Basilisk Ox fight, because that counterattack... Counter-Strike somehow didn't hit the Basilisk, because he was too high up, I'm guessing. But also last time on that fight, I had some weird shenanigans go on with the Ox. So, kind of traded off who was the issue there in this fight. And then, Goddess was good. I mean, can be better, but still, that was like 2 seconds off my best. Would have been nice to get the 3-hit to start it off, but I didn't think I could get there in time. So I, yeah, just only got the 2 to start off, and then she got ST off. I think if that happens, I should at least try for a spin attack or something, but to at least get ST meter up. But yeah, there it is. 131.58. We got it. We got 131. Finally. That is such a good time. What's next? That's a good question. I think I might try some dragon runs. I'm not sure if I'm ready to go for the full dragon grind yet, but I'd at least like to throw a few more attempts at the wall. Reattempt Jumi? I should eventually. Jumi's just so disheartening now. Just because, like, there's so much time to save, and then I hit 3 gem skip, and then I cry. But eventually I'll start throwing more attempts against the wall. I think I want to grind down Dragon before I grind down Jumi, though. Yeah, there we go. First run of the day too. That's awesome. Yeah, thank you, Orf. Well, yeah, I mean, I was kind of planning on maybe doing another run tonight if I had time, but it's kind of hard to follow that one up, and I think I just want to end the night with getting that time. I think that's what I want to go to bed with, so just do bingos now. Nah, not sure about that one, but yeah, that's gonna about do it for me tonight. So I mean, thanks to everyone that stopped in, Fonus, Arf, you guys have been here pretty long. I know Mono stopped in, Quixel, thanks for stopping in. And yeah, hopefully do some more Legend of Mana soon. So, have a good night, everyone.